marvelous introduction. You know, I was deeply touched by what I just saw. I haven't been able to stop crying over there. Not only the love I have when I come over here, but the faith of the people that are here. The joy of the hearts. That despite all obstacles in life, never give up. Never say no, never quit trying. You know, the world is there to beat you down, but you know, God gives us a heart that he beats up. And he allows to keep going and going and going, even when we feel compressed and we can't breathe anymore. He somehow gives us the ruach, the breath, his breath. The breath that he breathed into Adam when he took the sand from the ground, the dust of the earth, and he gave it life and breathed upon it. And all of a sudden, boom, there it came to life. And somehow in the midst of our choke, we still find that tiny bit of breath and that hope, that mustard-sized seed of faith. And I want to give it up for Katrina up here, and it was the most beautiful thing I'd seen in a long time. St. Francis of Assisi says to always speak the gospel and only use words if it's absolutely necessary. And some of us might have a hard time thinking about, what does that mean? What does it truly mean to speak the gospel without words? That's what it means. Amen. To get up there and to live a life of hope, regardless of your circumstances. In the midst of darkness, to have some form of light in a world that we know so desperately needs it. And to get up here, the courage of Dominique, and to share what you love most and what you're inspired by. Because I can guarantee you that we turn on the radio or we turn on the TV, there's not a whole lot of inspiration out there. But it's up to us, because God gives us that little flicker, that candle, that green light. If you've ever known what a confirmation is, you know, if you've got an important date with somebody, or if you've got an important date at a restaurant, or if you have a meeting or something, you know, and it's confirmed, that means that it's absolute. That's the thumbs up, that's the green light. And when you sit here and you're confirmed by God, what better way to understand a father's love than to get the green light and say, you know what, you are somebody, and I love you. And even if you were the only person in the world, I still would have came down and gone to the cross for you. That's what fearfully and wonderfully made means. It's not how we look. It's not what we do. It's not who our friends are. It's not how much money we have. It's how much love is in the giving that we present each day to a world that so desperately needs it. There's a richness in that. And when we see poverty, poverty is not your status financially, it's your spirit. But when you get that confirmation, you get that green light, God gives you that, and he says, blessed be you, my child, for you were created for such wonderful things, and you'll be destined for even more. And the only thing that can keep you from that promise is yourself. So when you stand in front of the man or the woman in the mirror, I want you to say that to yourself next time. The only one that can keep me from my own promises is me. You have to believe that you're bigger, that you're better, that you can do more. Because if you listen to the world's going to tell you the opposite. You know, when I started painting, I had the ability to do just that, to speak the gospel without words. I never understood how much it would transform lives and how many people would be affected by that. But yet every day God sends stories like this to just tell me that you're on the right track. You keep going. Keep having faith. You know, there was a lot of times I went home and I fell on the floor. I didn't even make it inside the front door. I fell on the grass and I was crying because the painting that I painted wasn't exactly what I wanted, or what I thought I could do, or wasn't as good as I thought I was, or I messed it up, but I saw the mistakes. Nobody else did. And our worst enemy is the person in the mirror that you're gonna sit there and have to convince that you are better than that. And you know, when Christ came down, he hung it all, and he bled for everything that we were not, he became so that we can become what we need to be. And I think all the paintings in the world that I've done wouldn't compare to a day in the life of someone like that with a heart that big and courage that big. So whatever it is that you have inside of you, please think about pushing everything aside that you feel is not good and grab hold of what you feel you can't let go of. Because life needs more people like her, like me, like you, 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 you. And I thank you for the tremendous privilege of having me come up here and paint something for you. And my talk was going to be on the Holy Spirit, but there's enough spirit in here already. I don't think I need to say much, right? The Holy Spirit is given to us as a gift of God to give us those seven things. And I know you guys know them because I heard them called out earlier. And the Spirit of God in Genesis hovered over the dark, over a world that was formless. And when it hovers over something that's dark, guess what happens? It instantly becomes light. And the first thing in Genesis, God said, "Let there be light." And to this day, we have not had to go outside and there be darkness because the sun has obeyed him from day one, thousands and thousands of years, and will continue to obey him till he says there will no longer be light. And so when God says you are fearfully and wonderfully made, he made that for all of eternity. Now you just gotta believe it. And once you believe it, it will never fail you to continue to keep shining light upon you because the sun didn't. And how much greater are you than the sun? How much greater are you than the birds? We just gotta believe it. And that's the power of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gives us the opportunity to understand who we really are. And it separates truth from lie, light from darkness, absence from plenty. You know, when Noah was on the ark, God had completely destroyed all of humanity and the earth, and he was very sad for what he had done because of the great hurt that it had caused his heart from people's disobedience and their sin. But he found one man righteous, one man willing to do and stand up for what was real and what was true. One man. And because of that one man, he saved all of humanity because there was one person that was willing to do. And that person was Noah. And at the end, it says that when the floodwaters began to cease and Noah was finding a place to park, he let out a bird. And what was the bird? It was a black crow, a grackle. And it said that the bird never returned to him. What he had released was that symbol of what was wicked, what was sinful, what was evil. The bird was black. And the bird never returned to him because what was evil didn't belong to him. What was evil must depart from him because what was coming was good, the promise of God. And then the second bird that he released, it says, was a white dove. And what happened was the white dove came back. And not only did it came back with an olive branch, the sign of life. Do you know that you can take an olive tree and you can burn it all the way to the floor and it'll still grow back next season? You cannot damage it. And that's why he goes to the Mount of Olives and he talks about the olive so much. Because no matter what you do to it, it can still survive. It'll still live. It'll make it through and it'll have a story next season to tell. And when that bird came back, it came back with a promise, it came back with a hope, it came back with a new life, it came back with a radiance. And that bird, as we know it, is the Holy Spirit, the sign of the dove. And if you look, many of you have seen the Passion of the Christ, right? And when you see Jesus, he looks up, what kind of bird is it that he sees? A white bird, the symbol of God's love that will forever be with him. And then when you look at the two crosses, there was something that landed on the cross of the one who didn't believe. And what bird was that? The blackbird. And what did it do? It came to steal, kill, and destroy by pecking its eyes. It's no question to who loves you. And the hardest part sometimes is how much do we really love ourselves? Imagine if we could love ourselves the way that God loves us and the amount of how much he loves us. What a difference we could make. I don't know about any of you, but when I answered the call, the only thing God asked me is, how do you want to make a difference? Give it to me. And I didn't know what to give him. Who am I? What have I done? But you know what? I could paint. He gave me that. And since I was little, I've been a painter since the time that I could remember it. He kept telling me to preach the gospel, preach the gospel, preach the gospel. And I didn't understand how until I gave him my hands. The only thing that he had given me, I gave back to him. And so in confirmation, we learned two things. Number one, that God really loves us. Number two, we got the green light. And the third thing I want you to take home with you is, what are you going to do with it? How can you use that to make a difference? What's inside of you? What has God given you that's something that you know you can do that wows or amazes others, or that you feel like you've always had in your heart and you've always loved? Give it to God. He'll use it. And that's where this came from. This was born out of me desiring to give to God. And I've traveled to Africa got invited to paint in Africa. Traveled to Colombia, to Mexico. I painted in places in Texas all over. And had so many opportunities to meet so many beautiful people and paint the love of God. And each time I come up here, it feels like the first. And so today I'm going to give you that beautiful gift. I'll share it with you. And I pray that you guys are blessed by it. But I pray more that you go home encouraged to know that God did not give me something or give her something or her something that he did not give you. He's no respecter of man. He never leaves anyone in the flock unattended. But something lives inside of you that you've been wanting to do your whole life, and you know, every one of you know exactly what that is. And you've got the green light. The only one to stop you is the man or the woman in the mirror, and it's your time to shine. I love you guys. God bless you. He painted a portrait and a picture of his love, and he did it without words in a way that inspires you. When he did this, it said, I love you more than anything. When he walked, he said, I'm coming towards you. When he did this, he said, I have peace with you. When he smiled, he said, you are radiant to me. And he did it without words. The words he used as fillers just to help the people understand. But I want to know what inspires you. And so I'm going to put the first word, and then I'll let you guys give me the next ones. All right. I got the first one up. Somebody give me another one.
Peace.
Oh, perfect. Faith, the substance of things, what?
unseen, but hope for.
Hope.
Prayers. So far, y'all like it? Hey, keep going.
Grace.
Mercy.
Who said that?
Mercy.
Trust God. That's the way the world sees it. They don't see it the right way. And so when they see it like that, all it looks like is a bunch of jumbled mess, and then they discredit what you're saying, and all of a sudden what you had, that hope, that joy, that peace, those prayers, that music, that mercy, that grace, how to conquer, to believe, have faith, trust, and hope, then all of a sudden begins to dissipate. And then becomes doubt, failure, disbelief, unwilling, not forgiven, unloved, idle, unforgiven, unpeaceful, chaos. But God has a different story for you. He can take whatever's upside down and he can make it right side up. All right, brother, take it away.
Thank you.
out of the void of the dark, the Lord said, let there be light, and there was light. And out of the radiance of the light came his tongues of fire. And in the middle of the beginning, when God created the light, the heavens and the earth and all things in between, he had a plan for us, for the Spirit hovers over things that are darkness and all of a sudden makes them light. But wherever the Spirit is, there also the fire is. And the fire down here symbolizes the resurrection of the Holy Spirit, the confirmation, and the things that come with it. Up here, the light represents God and shines upon all things. I hope you guys like it. Are you? S-T. Okay. I love y'all. Thank y'all very much.